Yorgos Papadopoulos, a leading liberal, was invited to dinner with the British military mission.
Διάφορες συζητήσεις και η τελευταία, η τελική ερώτηση.
We talked about various things.
Γιατί δεν θέλαμε το...
Then the last question the colonel asked me was, why don't you want your king back?
Δεν τον θέλαμε το βασιλιά, διότι ο βασιλιάς...
I said we don't want him back because he supported the Metaxas dictatorship in 1936, which denied us any freedom of speech and took away all civil rights. And I'm asking you, if your king did such things to you, would you want him? He didn't answer me on that.
Wherever he went, it was quite obvious that, alas, either or both, feared that we would reimpose the King of Greece under the protection of British bandits when Greece was liberated.
In March 1943, the widely respected Stephanos Sarafis was given the military command of Elas. However, SOE's successful cooperation with Elas did little to alter Foreign Office opinion that the main goal of the Greek resistance was to establish a communist regime in Greece after the war.
The Foreign Office would have preferred that there should be no resistance whatever. At one point, a leading official in the Foreign Office wrote a minute saying that the best level of sabotage in Greece would be no sabotage at all.
The Greek government in exile was based in Cairo. In August 1943, Brigadier Eddie Myers took a mixed delegation of resistance partisans there to discuss the future of the Greek king. Discussions broke down when the partisans, together with most of the Greek government in exile, demanded that he should agree to a referendum before his return to Greece.
Well, this was an anathema to the king of Greece himself, and it was an anathema to the Foreign Office, obviously. And the king of Greece became extremely worried and signaled Churchill and Roosevelt, who were then at Quebec conference, and they said, oh, you stick fast, you no need to sign away your abdication at this stage of the game.
The resistance delegation was dismissed as both irrelevant and embarrassing and was sent back to the mountains. For his pains, Myers was recalled to London and sacked. That same month, August 1943, at Quebec, the Allies decided they wouldn't need to involve Greece in any major military operations, and the Greek resistance therefore became less important. In Moscow in October, Stalin indicated to Anthony Eden that he was not concerned with Greece. This enabled the British to put their long-term political considerations in Greece first. In the War Cabinet in November 1943, it was decided to destroy the power of Eram Elas leaders and to build up the power of Zervas, now a royalist. In Greece itself, the continuing hostility between Eves and Elas erupted into open conflict.
Once the fighting broke out between Elas and Eves in October 1943, the British authorities decided that Elas was solely to blame for this outbreak, and therefore SOE was instructed to cut off all supplies to Elas until the fighting ceased.
Elas blamed Eves and accused it of collaborating with the Germans.
Zervas certainly had a means of contact with the Germans. He had at least a couple of officers who were members of Eves, stationed quietly in Janina, which was General Lanz's headquarters, General Lanz being the German commander, and these officers were certainly in irregular contact with Lanz and with Lanz's staff.
The war in Europe still had over a year to run. In Greece, a truce was arranged in January 1944 between the two resistance groups. Meanwhile, Elas had begun to organize society in the territory it had liberated. In April, it set up a provisional government in the mountains. Elections were held, and women were given the vote for the first time.
I remember that the government made beautiful things happen. and he rose to a higher level. The other governors had neglected the peasants. Beautiful things happened, like voting. I voted, and we helped in the local government in any way we could.
Η ανεξάρτηση και η κατανόηση που είχε δημιουργηθεί.
The solidarity and understanding that were generated up here in the mountains and the enthusiasm for self-government made people so much more aware and sophisticated that those of us who came up from Athens just couldn't believe it.
Στην Αθήνα και βρισκόταν σε αυτό το κλίμα, τα είχαμε. Και το ότι δημιουργήσαν, να πούμε, τα λαϊκά δικαστήρια στα χωριά.
People's courts were set up in the villages and I was elected to be a people's judge.
Βάλανε και εμένα δικαστή λαϊκών. Και κάναμε, να πούμε, τους διάφορες...
We judge various cases, things like property, mainly small cases, no murders or anything. I did my duty as I had been chosen and I became a judge. Although I was illiterate, of course. There were no lawyers here in the mountains. I don't know what was happening in the towns. Here in the villages, we didn't have to pay anyone acting as a lawyer. We only had people's judges who judged according to their consciences.
In general, the people were very pleased with this people's government. We had general assemblies every month, and every villager could air his grievances and criticize the chairman or councillor when he didn't do his duty. We made decisions for the whole village. Whatever happened in the village, everyone had to know about it. That was how self-government worked.
Ναι, όταν με την αυτοδιοίκηση που είχε αρχίσει τότε, να πούμε, ο κόσμος...
When we started to govern ourselves, we got encouraged. And people woke up, so to speak. We became more active and took more responsibility for ourselves.
Ζητήσαμε χωρισμόν εκκλησίες αυτοκράτους.
We wanted this government to agree to the separation of church and state, and that priests should complete secondary school and have theological degrees. In the meantime, we joined the resistance, and the churches contributed however they could.